Next item, just for the record as well, is vice chair.
Yes.
Nomination for vice chair.
And councillor Moira Butler.
Can I second that?
Okay. So then we go to members' code of conduct, declarations of interest. Are there any declarations tonight? Okay. Right. Apologies for absence. I've had Phil Davis, Alan McLaughlin, Alan McLaughlin, and Moira O'Donnell. Are there any others? Okay, thank you for that. Minutes of the last meeting, which is under item 3. First of all, can someone declare that they are a true record? Okay, and are there any matters arising from those minutes? Okay, lovely. So the next item on the agenda then is the Wirral Youth Zone in the Hive, and we're going to have a presentation by Stuart, who's going to come along tonight to, have you got anything to show us? Good lad. So Stuart, over to you mate. Stuart Barnes, the Hive, imagine.
Well, thank you very much for the opportunity to come and tell you something about the Hive Wirral Youth Zone. There are a few familiar faces in here who will already know quite a bit about the project, so please excuse me if I'm telling you things that you already know about the project. It is a major investment in young people on the Wirral, and we opened just over 2 months ago at the beginning of April. This worked a minute ago when I was showing how to work it, and it is now. Okay, just to give you some background and some context, the Hive Wirral Youth Zone is the eighth such similar project to open over recent years in the country, predominantly in the northwest. And it's developed by a charity called Onside Youth Zones. Onside exists purely to create and develop high-spec, large-scale youth zones, initially across the northwest, but now expanding nationally. They are a charity, and that is their sole objective, is to create projects. At the point that those projects are agreed and are moving forward, a local charity is formed. So Wirral Youth Zone is a locally led, independent charity, but it's part of the Onside network. It was developed to replicate the very successful model of Bolton Lads and Girls Club in other areas predominantly of disadvantage in the country. That was a large-scale youth initiative that was very successful. Lots of people from other areas kept visiting and saying, oh, we want one of these in our areas. But people didn't actually then go and do that. So Onside was created purely to do that, to replicate that model. It's a charity, very much an independent charity, but with a strong private sector involvement. We have a board which is very private sector led and gives that level of governance and accountability. Wirral is the eighth youth zone to open. The Onside movement started not even initiative and now expanding into London as well. Wirral is the best youth zone in the network. I have no hesitation in saying that. We've been able to learn from the experience of the others as they've been developed. So the design of our building, the how the offer is put together, we've learnt very much from the others, and I do believe we have a very good facility. A recent visit by the former Minister for Children and Families, Edward Timpson, he said that he believed that it was the best facility for young people in the country at the moment, which is fantastic for us in Wirral. So what does the youth zone offer? Well, we offer at least 20 activities every session. So the youth zone has a whole range of sports activities. We've got a four-court sports hall, we've got a boxing gym, we've got a fitness suite, we have a climbing wall, so all sorts of sports activities, arts activities, we've got a creative arts room, we've got a multimedia room, we've music room, recording studio, radio station. We even have a salon on site as well, with hair and beauty and makeup and a barber's area. We do cooking activities, we have a skate park, we have a football pitch on the roof, which doesn't sound like it should work, but for those of you who've seen it, you'll agree with me that it is. It does have the wow factor. So a lot of different activities. But it's a lot more than that. If all we do is just run activities, then actually, we're just providing leisure activities, and the youth zone is intended to be so much more than that. It's about personal development. It's about ensuring other people raise their aspirations, achieve their potential, enhance their prospects, improve their health and young being. So through all of those activities, we're looking at how we can help improve achieve development in their own lives. You know, the gym is not just the gym. You know, young people come into the gym, they will achieve a fitness goal, but the workers in there will help them to understand the steps to achieving a goal and how those could be applied to school or other aspects of their life. We run employability and enterprise programs, both as a culture and an ethos throughout the youth zone, but also very specific as well. We've got a team of staff and volunteers. We've just been amazed by the number of local people who have got on board and are giving of their time and volunteering to make a difference for young people. And the building itself is designed to create a safe environment, an environment and atmosphere where young people will take part and will engage. So as I mentioned, it's a safe, supportive, inspiring place, and that's as much about the team as it is about the facility, offering a very quality provision for all young people, regardless of their background or where they come from. We work with young people from the age of 18 to 19 or up to 25 for those with a disability, and it's very affordable. It's £5 a year annual membership and 50 pence per visit. So for 50 pence a young person could come at 4 o'clock school, and on a senior night they can stay till 10 o'clock, so that's 6 hours for 50 pence, so that's less than 10 pence an hour, parents as well are talking to us about positive experiences their children are having, progress that they're already making. Some generally in terms of confidence and self-esteem, some in terms of new ideas, new aspirations from new activities that they're taking part in. Other really significant things, one that's mentioned here, a young person who is an elective mute and wasn't talking at school or at home, but is talking to our climbing instructor on the wall. Some huge progress. And young people themselves are giving us a lot of feedback. Our email and Twitter was full on Monday after we'd done a special event over the weekend. Lots of young people talking about that. But already raising aspirations. A young person who took the time to tell us that having come to the Hive feels they've found their home from home, something that many do tell us, that not only the facility is amazing and safe, but the staff are polite and engaged with young people, actually doing things with them, helping people to feel encouraged and encouraging others to come as well. And I think a key there is, the facility is great for those of you who've seen it. It is an amazing facility, but it will only achieve its potential with the team of people who are working there and who will use it to that. Not just the staff, but as I mentioned, the hundreds of volunteers getting involved. Another comment from one of our young people. We had a number of young people work with us for the 18 months prior to opening, so that we always ensured that young people's voices and opinions were at the heart of what we were doing, so they were involved in everything from appointing the architects to choosing the name, designing the branding, working on publicity, working on peer-led consultations. They sat on every interview panel for every single member of staff that we've employed, which was fantastic to watch, right through to recording a promotional rap with John Barnes. If you haven't heard, you can find it on YouTube, and you might wish to stop it before the end when I do my bit. But lots of good news stories already after just 9 weeks of the potential over the coming months and years to make a difference to young people on their own is immense. So already we have a membership of over 4,200 young people from across the Wirral. There are young people from every ward in Wirral and across the age range. We were given an initial target of 3,000 young people in the first 12 months, which many people locally said would never be achieved. We achieved 3,000 members in less than 3 weeks, which just shows the level of demand and interest from young people. We've created 60 jobs locally, and that's likely to increase, having exceeded our target for young people in order to continue providing a quality service. We are looking to increase our team. At the point of doing the presentation, we've recruited over 75 volunteers. Those are 75 volunteers who have applied, been interviewed, been DBS checked, had references, and done safeguarding training and are active. Since opening, a lot more have expressed an interest and are at various points in that progression, so we expect by September to have about 150 active volunteers every month working on the project. And in time, we're very confident that Wirral Youth Zone will significantly contribute to reducing antisocial behaviour in the area, and that comes with a joined up approach of working with lots of other people. Every other youth zone since opening has seen a reduction of between 52 and 77% in antisocial behaviour in the immediate vicinity of the youth zone. Obviously we're a little too early to be able to report on that, but we're working to the same model. We're working very much with other agencies and organisations to look at that. So that's something that we very much hope we will see very soon. We hope to improve the perceptions of young people in the community as well. So many of our young people are already getting involved in so many positive things. And very soon they're going to be out and about throughout the bit of slide, as I always do, and end up digressing. But young people have always been at the heart of the project and been involved right from the outset. So as I said, been involved in the design and branding. This group of young people that we draw from right across the world, their views and opinions were sought on virtually everything. They went to all the other youth centres in the network and gave their feedback on what they felt worked, what didn't. So they, you know, influenced the design. Even when the initial design came back and it had boys' toilets and girls' toilets, this group of young people said, no, you know, that can facilitate bullying. We just want individual cubicles. So that was redesigned with the young people's feedback. As I said, they've been involved in recruitment. Consultation, this group led a peer-led consultation about transport issues, which is one of the big questions, and spoke and recorded information that they collected from over 750 other young people. This group is forming the start of our Young Leaders project, which many more will join. They're also fantastic ambassadors. You know, some of these young people were quite shy to start with. They've subsequently been to present to potential supporters. They spoke to rooms full of the big company chief execs. This group have just recently been invited to write the introduction to the annual report for the Queen's Trust, and then we'll go to London for the launch of that, and hopefully meet members of the royal family. The Queen's Trust is one of the big capital supporters of the youth zone. A couple of them are also going to London on Monday. Another major supporter of the youth zone is the Garfield Western Foundation, which is one of the three or four biggest charitable funders in the country. They contributed a significant amount to the capital cost. So some of our young people are actually presenting to their board meeting on Monday, which is a fantastic experience for them. So updates of where we're at. You know, you've probably driven past if not been in. The building completed in February. Before opening on the 8th of April, we invited virtually everybody we could possibly invite to come in and have a look, to look at the facilities, meet the team, and then we opened on the 8th of April, as I mentioned, 3,000 members within 3 weeks, which was our target for 12 months. We have 22 founder patrons on board. That's local businesses, local individuals who are supporting the ongoing running costs along with the local authority. So huge support from the people of Wirral, from the businesses of Wirral, all working together. And then we continue to consult, collaborate, work in partnership with young people, companies, other organisations. The Youth Zone is very much about additionality, collaboration. We're not here to take over what anyone else is doing. You know, so lots of other people working with young people, we're working with them, look at what we can learn from other people working across the world, how we can work together. We've struck up lots of partnerships already, lots and lots. And the Youth Zone and all the Youth Zone network is very much a four-way partnership, and that is how it succeeds. Young people are at the heart. The local authority are very much part of the project. OnSide will not proceed with any Youth Zone project without the full engagement of the local authority. And we're very grateful for that. And that's not just financial involvement, that's a real working relationship. The Youth Zone is an open access, universal youth provision, something that, you know, we have seen reduced over recent years. We're not the experts, and neither do we set ourselves out to be the experts in different activities or sports or a lot of targeted support. So we need to work collaboratively with the local authority and other organisations. The private sector is a very key part, both in terms of they are contributing over 50% of the revenue costs. We have a private sector-led board, so I'm held very, very accountable, both in terms of the quality of what we do and the finance. And then the community as well. As I say, we're working with lots of different groups, lots of people from the local community involved as volunteers, which is absolutely brilliant. skills, but IT is not